last week we talked about two methods to create zipper teeth, and I told you I had a third method to share with you, and that's what we're going to talk about today. And the third method involves using brushes. Brushes are super helpful for fashion designers if you are flat sketching, so you want to make sure you really get familiar with them. And if you're not familiar with them yet, you can start with today's video. So make sure you hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, and let's get started.
Illustrator can create five different types of brushes: scatter, art, calligraphic, bristle, and pattern brushes. For flat sketches, we're usually using art brushes or pattern brushes, and in this video, we're going to be creating a pattern brush. The first thing you'll do is create a single zipper tooth shape, and that can vary depending on the type of zipper you're using, but for our purposes, I'm going to use the shape of Vizlan teeth because it's probably the most recognizable. So I went on the internet and searched for zipper teeth and found this picture, and I'm going to use it as a template to draw the tooth shape. So first, let's drag it onto the page, and then using the transparency panel, lighten the image. As you've seen in previous videos, this step makes it easier to trace. Last thing you'll do before beginning to sketch is to lock the picture. Select it and go to Object, Lock Selection. I'm actually going to do one more thing before I start sketching, and that is to mark the middle of the zipper tooth with a ruler guide. I'm doing this so I'll end up with a perfectly symmetrical object. So bring up your rulers and drag a guide to the center of the object you plan to draw. You may have to eyeball this a little bit. Now, let's get the pen tool and begin sketching. You can start from the center at the top or the bottom, but you just want to make sure that you're creating one continuous line around the edge of the object. Click and drag those direction handles whenever you're creating a curved line, and be sure to drag towards the direction you're drawing. Once the first half is complete, select it using the black arrow, go to the Reflect tool, place the cursor over the center guide, press the Alt or Option key, and then click once with your mouse. The Reflect Options box will appear and you'll choose a vertical axis. Then press the Copy button. Make sure you choose Copy, not OK. Now that you've got one full zipper tooth drawn, you're going to use my favorite tool, Shape Builder, to close the shape and then fill it with white, which you can also do while you're using Shape Builder. To create a complete repeat, you'll need two additional zipper teeth, one above and one more next to the first tooth. So we're going to reflect again, this time across a horizontal axis, and again press Copy, and then move it into place. For the last zipper tooth, select the first object, grab the Reflect tool, and we'll use the Alt or Option key again this time, but you're going to align your cursor with the center of the second tooth before you mouse click. And when you do, your object should reflect into the exact spot it needs to be to align with the top object. Now, before I do anything else, I'm going to tweak the shape of the teeth a little just to get them to fit a little better. And it's a good idea to do the same tweaks to all of the teeth since they're all supposed to be symmetrical. So whatever small tweaks you do to one, you'll want to do to all of them. You may even want to fix one and then re-reflect them. I also decided that I want to bring the two bottom teeth to the front. I just like how that looks better than having them to the back. So if you just drag this into the brushes panel, you'd end up with a wonky zipper brush with weird teeth spacing. And the reason is because, as is, this artwork is not in repeat.
So when you create a repeating pattern in Illustrator, whether it's a swatch or a brush, you're creating a tile. And like tiles that you lay on the floor, the artwork from top to bottom and side to side need to align so that when you place another tile above it or below it or next to it, the artwork appears seamless.
So to define what part of this artwork will be the repeating tile, I'm going to create what's called a definition box using the rectangle tool. And what I like to do when I'm trying to align two identical objects and create a repeat is to go from the center of one of the objects to the center of the other. So I'm going to drag another guide to the second bottom tooth, and that'll make it really easy to complete the next step. Get the rectangle tool and draw a box around the repeat. Now, top to bottom doesn't need to be super precise. It just needs to be as tall as the artwork. But side to side, be sure the edges of the rectangle fall exactly at the center of each object. And it's really easy to do that since you have the guides already placed at the center points. The last few things you need to do before creating your brush is to remove any color on the definition box and then send to back. This is Illustrator's way of understanding what part of these motifs it will use as the main part of the brush that will repeat over and over again. So after you've sent the definition box to the back, you're going to select the teeth and the definition box and drag them into the brushes panel. When the new brush options appear, choose Pattern Brush. From here, you can name your brush and choose a colorization method.
And if you're unfamiliar with the colorization methods or how to choose one, I have a whole video that explains it in detail, and I'll link it in the description below.
Press OK and test your brush. Create a line and then select the brush from the brushes panel. To color the brush, change the color of your stroke. And that's pretty much it. Of course, one of the things I love the most is that you can now save this in your library so you never have to create another zipper brush again unless you have some type of novelty teeth. Now here's your bonus tip. Sometimes you'll have to draw a sketch where the zipper is partially open and you'll need to show the teeth separated as opposed to interlocking like when the zipper is closed. So while you're creating your zipper brush, you want to also create brushes for a single row of teeth. And this is very simple because you already have the motif drawn. Isolate a single tooth and create another definition box just around the one tooth. Again, the height of the box just needs to be as tall as the artwork, but your side-to-side repeat should align with the actual paths of your zipper tooth. This time, I'm going to just rely on the smart guides to align my definition box rather than drag physical guides. But notice I'm not going to the edges of the black line. I'm aligning the box with the path that was drawn. Make sure you take note of this. If you drag your definition box to the edges of the black line, the repeat will be a little off. Repeat all of the previous steps to save the brush, and now you have teeth for one side of your open garment. And yes, of course, I have a quick way for you to create the teeth for the opposite side. Duplicate the brush, double-click it to open the settings, and choose Flip Across from the Flip menu. The preview of the artwork in the brushes panel won't change, but when you use it, the teeth will be on the opposite side. That one's a real time saver, and I hope you love it as much as I do. You can add a zipper pull, and I'm just pulling one for my library's panel and sizing it down to fit the teeth. And then use the rectangle tool to create a zipper stop at the bottom to finish this off.
Make sure you tune in next week when we'll be creating the zipper slider, and I'll show you a great way to set yourself up so that you can easily change it next season if you need to customize it, which a lot of designers do enjoy doing because they'll use their zipper puller as another vehicle for their branding. So check out the links in the description, like, subscribe, share the video if you found it helpful, and I'll see you in the next one.